وما أرسلنا من قبلك إلا رجالا نوحي إليهم فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
إن شاء الله this is the last point بإذن الله الكريم for our first day of the topic and how should a student of knowledge build his library. Now we're going to speak about the fourth point, which is the last inshallah, the library of a student of knowledge according to ulumul Quran and the tafsir. We have to know, or the students of knowledge need to know, min kutub at-tafsir ma yu'inu ala fahmi kitabillah. Talib al-ilm needs to have understanding of the Quran of Allah, or something that's going to help him understand the Quran. And that which will yu'inu ala tadabbur kitabillah ta'ala, something that will help you to ponder and understand the Quran. And that which will give you the effort and the ability, to extract understanding from the book of Allah. And there are many books that have been written that work towards the Quran, and it's some of them that are for beginners and some of them that are for what? And mutawwalat, who are for the muntahiyat, people who've reached that level of just researching, going in depth. So inshallah, we're going to speak about that, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, those books. I'm going to start with the mukhtasarat, the books that are abridged, they're very simple, that every talib al-ilm should have in his library in order to understand the book of Allah. The Arabic is very simple, and it's to the point. From those books is the tafsir of al-allamatul usuli al-shaykh Abdurrahman ibn Nasir al-Sa'di. This kitab is munasib lil-muta'allim wa ghayr al-muta'allim. This is for the one who's learning, the one that's teaching, the one that is mutakhassis fi ulum shar'iyya, and it's for the tabib, the doctor, it's good for the muhandis, the engineer, for the, anyone who, that book is, it's a book that's for everyone. Kullu yastafidu minhu. Everyone would benefit from it. Why? لأنه سيغة بإسلوب العصر. The wording, the terminology is according to the Arabic language that's used today. It's not that, it's the ones that are hard and, efforts you have to go to find, understand. So this tafsir, tafsir مختصر جيد and it's beneficial. And it's sad that some people don't even realize how great this book is. مع ذلك لا يستفيدون منه. Also there's a tafsir written by Shaykh Faisal ibn Mubarak which is called توفيق الرحمن لدروس القرآن. Even though this book رغم اختصاره, even though it's a small abridged book, very abridged, it's مطبوع قديم. It's been published long time ago, and now recently, ولله الحمد والمنه, طبع مرة ثانية. It's been published recently. It's been published طبع في أربعة أجزاء. It's been published in four volumes. And this book, توثيق الرحمن لدروس القرآن by Sheikh Faisal Mubarak, is abridged of مختصر, is a مختصر of what? الطبراني, الطبري's book, ابن جرير الطبري's تفسير, and the تفسير of بغوي, and تفسير ابن كثير. Those three tafsir, he did abridged. He took all the three tafsir and he abridged them. And this is his tafsir. This kitab is nafi', very beneficial fi babi. لمن لا يسعفه الوقت بالرجوع إلى الأصول القديمة. Especially for a person who cannot research in these three books. So for example, sometimes you're not able to go to Ibn Jarir al-Tabari's kitab, or you can't go to al-Baghawi's tafsir, or you're not able to go to tafsir ibn Kathir, رحمه الله. Easy for you to just to go to the Tawfiq, Ar-Rahman لدروس القرآن by Faisal Mubarak for the three that we just mentioned. It's very important, mashallah. Also, one of the abridged book that is written is the Tafsir al-Jalalain. Tafsir al-Jalalain, it's called Jalalain because two scholars who both their names start with Jalaluddin have both written it. The first one is Jalaluddin al-Mahalli and Jalaluddin al-Suyuti. This book, أشبه ما يكون بالمتن. This book is like a written متن. It's like it is متن علمي متين بحاجة إلى مطالعة حواشي. This book is beneficial and it has حواشي on it. It has footnotes and stuff on it. Beneficial explanations and it sometimes, and it requires, this book does require, جلال الدين السيوطي and جلال الدين المحلي's كتاب مختصر الجلالين. It requires إلى من ينبه على ما فيه من الملحوظات. It does need for a student of knowledge, who's especially a beginner, to have a scholar or a person of knowledge who can alert him on the mistakes that happens. Because the kitab is beneficial, no doubt, but it has mistakes in it because the two scholars that I mentioned, Jalaluddin al-Mahalli and Jalaluddin al-Suyuti, both of them have aqeedah issues. So when a student of knowledge hasn't got, he's not grounded in aqeedah, he may find masail that will do iltibas and that will confuse him or throw him off the correct manhaj and the correct aqeedah. ولذلك الشيخ عبد الكريم الخضير جزاه الله خيرا وحفظه الله. What he did was he was trying to do the sharh of Jalaluddin al-Suyuti, Tafsir al-Jalalain. He was trying to do the sharh of it. And what he did was, عبد الكريم الخضير, he started to do Tafsir of Surah al-Fatiha, and it took him and the Tafsir al-Fatiha 4 hours, 4 different hours to explain it. So it was long, very, very long. Just Surah Al-Fatiha, it was very long, his explanation of it. This is Surah Al-Fatiha, and the Kitab is a Mukhtasar. So it wasn't possible for him to finish the whole Tafsir book like that. If Fatiha has four tapes, what do you think Baqarah is going to be, and what do you think, and stuff like that. But anyways, the Kitab, Tafsir al-Jalalain, the Rub' al-Akhir, the last fourth chapters, the last, if the Tafsir al-Jalalain is divided into four, the last fourth section, Abdul Razak al-Afifi, what he did was he put ta'liqat on it. He didn't finish it off. He done ta'liqat and ta'aqubat, and he corrected the issues, the mistakes. This is when the book Tafsir al-Jalalain was a muqarrar. It used to be from the curriculum that the students used to study in the ma'ahid al-ilmiyah in tafsir. So he stood up and he worked on it. Na'am. And one of the amazing things in this book, subhanallah, shakhs min tulab al-ilm in Yemen, one of the students that was in Yemen, qabla qarn, maybe 100 years ago, or maybe even more slightly, he wanted to read Tafsir al-Jalalain. So issue came up to him, which was, can he read it without purification, or does he read it without purification? So the people that were around him said to him, look, Tafsir al-Jalalain and the Quran, which one has more wordings? Is it the wording of the two scholars, Jalaluddin al-Suyuti and Jalaluddin al-Mahalli, are their words more than the Quran? If the words of theirs is more than the Quran, then you will take the aghlabi, the majority, so that you don't have to do wudu. But if the Quran, the kalam of Allah, is more, then you would have to do dhahara. That's what he said. So he went home and he started to count. He went home, this student, and he started to count. Letter, he started to do it. Letter, because they said letters. So he said, add al huruf al Quran, wa huruf al tafsir. When he went to Surah al Muzammil, he started from the top and he reached Surah al Muzammil. He realized that the Tafsir al-Jalalain had one letter more than the Quran. And then the issue came off him. ثُمَّ مِنَ الْمُدَثِّرِ, from Mudathir onwards. Sorry, when he read Surah al-Muzammil, they were equal, parallel to each other. The kalam of Jalal, both of the Jalalain, Jalaluddin Surah Jalal Mahalli, and the Quran was the same, Surah Al-Muzammil. But when he reached Surah Al-Mudathir, the tafsir became a bit more, so he didn't have to do his dahara. This is just what they mentioned, the ulama. Also, there's another tafsir which is bigger and beneficial as well, and famous, sorry. Tafsir Al-Baydawi. It's bigger than Jalaluddin al-Suyuti and Jalaluddin al-Mahalli's tafsir, which is Jalalain. It's bigger than it. The student of knowledge will benefit from it. Rather, especially what connects to ma yata'alluq bi sana'ati al-lafziyya, according to the structure of wordings, is very beneficial. And it has hawashi adida. It has footnotes and explanations that have been put in it from the scholars. And this shows you the effort that the scholars put on this book, inayatul ajiba. Subhanallah, the hawashi that have been put in it alone reached 120 hawashiya. 120 hawashi have been put on it. Rather, if you go to the nusakhs that have been published from the nusakhs Turkey and Syria, the nusakhs, the manuscripts that are the Turkish manuscripts and the Syrian manuscripts, you would find that the scholars, they put a lot of hawashi on the tafsir. So you won't even find the tafsir by itself unless there's a hawashi on it. Also, one of the tafsir that have been written is tafsir, which I'm still speaking about the mukhtasarat, the abridged. Is the tafsir of Tashil by that's written by Jazzi al Kelbi. It's tafsir Tashil by Jazzi al Kelbi, which is a mukhtasar wa muharrar wa mutqin wa madbut. It's a tafsir which is collective, organized, and done very well. Also, there's a tafsir in Nasafi, which is from the mukhtasarat. The tafsir al-Nasafi is also one of the tafsir that have been written. But as I said before, all the mukhtasarat that I mentioned now, that I keep mentioning, none of them is as good as the tafsir of Shaykh Abdurrahman ibn Nasir al-Saudi and the tafsir of Shaykh Faisal bin Mubarak. These two, as a talib ilm, you need it. It should be in your maktaba. La siyama dhiq al-waqt. Especially at Faisal Mubarak's tafsir, it's good because when you are a person who is not able to go to the tafsir Ibn Jarir al-Tabari and tafsir al-Baghawi and tafsir al-Kathir, then you can just quickly look at Faisal Mubarak's tafsir, which is very, very beneficial. Baydawi's tafsir is very good. With the hawashi, it makes a good benefit for the student of knowledge. Remember, other than the tafsir of Faisal Mubarak and Abdurrahman Nasir al-Sa'di, like Jalaluddin's tafsir and Baydawi's tafsir, you need a teacher who's there, who's going to teach you the ins and the outs, because there are masail that are khata'un in it, that are wrong. From the tafsir that are mutawwalat, that are big, is from them is the tafsir of Imam Hafiz Ibn Kathir rahimahullah. So the first one we're going to mention is tafsir Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala. This book is beneficial. Tafsir Mukathir is a kitab مناسب لكافة المتعلمين. It's beneficial for every learner. قد يميله غير المتخصص في السنة لكثرة ما يسوق من آثار وبالأسانيد. The people who are not specialized in the science of hadith may find it hard to go to the Tafsir Mukathir because he brings a lot of narrations. You know, he does takhrijat of the hadith in his tafsir. And there are takrarat. He keeps repeating some narrations a lot of the times. Whenever he needs it, he'll bring it back again. If the person doesn't like that and he doesn't like hadith, he just doesn't like this asanid and this chain narration, that's not his field, he just wants to see the speech, then mashallah, what you can do is you can get the mukhtasar of Shaykh Ahmed Shakir's book. Shaykh Ahmed Shakir abridged Fathul Bari. He abridged Tafsir Hafiz Ibn Kathir. And he called it Umdatul Tafsir and Hafiz Ibn Kathir. From them also, that was Ahmed Shakir ones. Also, there's a Tafsir al-Ali al-Qadir by who? Shaykh Muhammad Naseeb al-Rufa'i rahimahullah ala al-jami'. He abridged them. These mukhtasarat, the two I mentioned, these are mukhtasarat jayyidatun li tafsir Hafiz ibn Kathir ala anna al-asl la yughna anhu. Like, you don't think, because you took these two abridged, and they're both abridged of Fathul Bari. I don't know why I keep saying Fathul Bari. I mean, they are both abridged of Tafsir ibn Kathir. So the Mukhtasarat of Ahmed Shakir and Muhammad Naseeb al-Rufa'i are both good. Lakin, don't depend on these two and forget to look at Tafsir al-Mukathir itself. This, you cannot leave that from your library. Lakin, anyone who doesn't have that mail, that love and that, mashallah, interest, more like, in the science of hadith and takhrij and tasrih and tad'if, then for him, he might find hardship in just going to Tafsir al-Kathir because of the asanid and the riwayat he brings. So he can just study from straight, go to Umdat al-Tafsir and Hafiz al-Kathir and Taysir al-Ali al-Qadir. But if you have mail in your heart and you, mashallah, you like hadith and you like to see asanid and riwayat, then go to the Tafsir al-Kathir because tastafidu minha. Another tafsir, which is the tafsir of Imam al-Baghawi. And this is a tafsir al-Athari al-Salafi. This is a tafsir full of athar, narration, straight to the sahabas and the atba'a tabi'in. And its creed of Imam al-Baghawi is, because he's the author of Kitab Shahih al-Sunnah, He is الإمام البغوي is book is one of the strongest books in عقيدة and in منهج and تفسير القرآن. He's على منهج أهل السنة. إمام شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية praised this book and so did أئمة السنة. They praised the book of إمام البغوي. And if you look at the book, the reality of the book shows you that. وواقع الكتاب يشهد لذلك بهذا. The book itself, when you read it, you realize that it's got all of these benefits. Also, there's a bridge of that one, Baghawi's Kitab, which is called Tafsir al-Khazin. And it's a mukhtasar of Baghawi's Kitab. Even that though there's idafat, he adds some things to it as well. وله شهرة وانتشار بغير هذه البلاد. السعودية, it's not really famous, this book. Baghawi's Idafat. This one, Tafsir al-Khazin, which is a bridge of Baghawi's Kitab. It's not really spread and it's not famous in Saudi Arabia especially. Because the author who done a bridge of the Kitab of Tafsir al-Baghawi, he mentions things that are Sufism and stuff like that. After that, the Tafsir of Zamakhshari, Al-Kishaf. This Kitab is a Tafsir, lakin in it is I'tizaliyat. There's a lot of the belief of the Mu'tazila in it. مسائل الإيمان and issues that are corruption and أصول المعتزلة الشيطان. He's got that book. When the student of knowledge reads this book, he should be very careful. If he brings it into his library, chooses to bring it into his library, then he should be very, 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 very cautious and be very concerned. Because this kitab, it has many things of i'tizal. And he's eloquent in the way he speaks. Very eloquent. The student who reads this book will benefit through mainly one thing, which is in the language. في باب اللغة ناحية اللغوية. From the angle of language, he is a bahar. He is a bahar. لا ساحل له. If a person chooses to get that book into his maktaba and he wants to look into it sometimes and get some benefits from it, then no doubt he needs to get Ibn Munir's tanbihat of that kitab. Ibn Munir, he does tanbihat. He alerts the places where al-imam, where Zamakhshari done his corruptions or deviation comes with. So with that, you will be able to distinguish between what's Aqidah al-Sunnah by getting Ibn Numair's book, who speaks about it and his corruptions. Also, there's a Tafsir al-Khatib al-Shirbini. Shirbini's tafsir is simple. All it does is combines between tafsir of Baydawi and the tafsir of Zamakhshari. He got Zamakhshari's tafsir and he got Baydawi's tafsir and both of them brought it together, and that's what his tafsir is based upon. Last but not least, inshallah, one of the books of tafsir is the tafsir of Imam al-Mufassirin. He is the Imam of all Mufassirin. Ibn Muhammad, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari. This is the best book in tafsir ala al-itlaq, without no exceptions. The best book in totality. There is no book like the tafsir of Ibn Jarir al-Tabari. This book, if it's not wajib for it to be in your house as a student of knowledge, then it is sunnah mu'akkada, wala shak. Because this kitab, especially if you're a student of knowledge and you're seeking the deen of Allah and you're able to read it, then it's lazim upon you that you know you have this book in your library. It is lazim. And this kitab is tafsir kitab, it is of ala al-nafi'u fil ghaya. It's beneficial at peak. It's a book that is based upon sunnah and based upon asanid. When he brings the tafasir, what he does is yajma'u tafasir al-salaf bil-asanid. He brings Abdullah ibn Abbas, and then Ibn Jarir will mention his chain of narration to Ibn Abbas. The kitab has been published many times. First time it was published by the publishing company called Maymina. When Maymina published it first, after them came Taba'atul Bawlaq. Taba'atul Bawlaq, when that came out, Mahmoud Shakir, who's the brother of Ahmed Shakir, he done tahqiq of the kitab ila Surah Ibrahim fi 16 juz'an. إلى سورة إبراهيم 16 volumes. He done تحقيق of it. أكمل فيما أكمل فيما بعد. After what he left, it got finished off. It got done. After محمود شاكر, دكتور عبد الله التركي, who is the مدير of رابط عالم إسلامي, he came and he done the same. على كل حال, the طابعة of شيخ محمود شاكر is the best. The best. The طالب should put effort and strength in making sure that he brings that one in his library. Did I say Mahmoud Shakir? I meant Ahmed Shakir. Sorry, Ahmed Shakir himself is the one that done the haqiqah of it. So the first taba'a that came out, the first taba'a that ever came out in Tafsir ibn Jarir al-Tabari was the taba'a, the publishing of Maymeeniyya. That was the first. Then taba'a Bawlak came. Then Ahmed Shakir, the haqiqah of it, Surah Ibrahim. And after that, it got finished. Then Dr. Abdullah Turki came, he done all the Tafsir ibn Kathir, Surah Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, he came and he done the haqiqah of it. على كل حال, the taba'a of Ahmed Shakir is the best. If that person gets the taba'a of Ahmed Shakir, and he also gets the taba'a of taba'a Bawlak, which is the asal, that's the original one that Ahmed Shakir depended on when he was doing his tahqiq, when he was looking at the book, then the person would come out with benefits of it. Abdullah Turki's one is good, lakin, you know, I haven't really looked into it that much myself, so I wouldn't know the ins and the outs regarding that. Also, one of the tafasir that are good, especially when you're looking at it from the angle of the language, is Bahr al-Muhit ibn Hayyan al-Andalusi. Al-Bahr al-Muhit is a kitab yakadu yakunu kitab al-lugha. It's as though you're reading a book of the Arabic language. You're just reading the Arabic language that you're learning the Arabic language from. It's a kitab, when you read it, it's strong and solid in the Arabic language. It has mukhtasarat. It has books that have been abridged from it, like Nahr al-Mad min al-Bahr. Also, Ad-Durr al-Laqit min al-Bahr al-Muhit. This kitab, it benefits you from the language perspective. So for example, you want to learn the Nahw and the Sarf and the Balagh and the Adab in an ayah, you would find benefit in it from this great Imam Abu al-Hayyan, Bahru al-Muhit. Also, there's a tafsir of Fakhruddin al-Razi. He's one he called tafsir, is known as Tafsir al-Kabir. It's known as Tafsir al-Kabir. This tafsir, if you're not a person, لم يتأهل للنقد, you're not able to refute, you're not able to push away the doubts, then for you at this moment, this kitab is not of any benefit for you. It's a kitab that reaches, it will confuse you, especially but Fakhruddin is clever in the way he wrote his book. Sometimes he will bring doubts that he believes in. He'll bring that doubt to you. When he brings it to you, he won't bring it to you directly. He will bring it to you from an angle of another scholar or somebody else. He won't refute it properly. He will refute it with very weak argument to make this doubt look strong to you. Because he wants to make affirm that in your heart. But when he's against something that goes against the Aqeedah Ahlul Sunnah and he's not of it, he will refute it with strength and power. This is what he's known to do. One of the tafsir that the student of knowledge should also look into is the tafsir of Ibn Atiyyah. Tafsir Ibn Atiyyah, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah praised it, and that kitab is Matbu' al-Mutadawwal al-Muhaqqaq, huwa kitab al-Nafi'. Also, one of the tafsir that are very beneficial is the tafsir al-Alusi. Its name is called Rawh al-Ma'ani fi tafsir al-Qur'an al-Azim wa Sab' al-Mathani. It's written by Abi al-Thana' Mahmud al-Alusi. He's the Jadd, the grandfather of, and it's not Mahmoud Shukri, his grandfather. هذا التفسير جمع في ما هب ودب. This kitab, if tafsir, you will find everything is in there. Good, bad, it's all in it. فيقول, sometimes he will say, قال الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية. Sometimes he will say, قال الإمام المحقق ابن القيم. And then sometimes he will come and say, قال محي الدين ابن العربي. محي الدين ابن العربي قدس الله روحه. He will say, for example, Muhyiddin ibn Arabi, he had a kafir, kaffarahu al-ulama. The ulama, he believed wuhdatul adyan, wuhdatul wujud. He believed that everyone and everything that you see, Allah is inside it. Muhyiddin ibn Arabi. And it's not and author of the Kitab Ahkam al-Quran, which we're going to come to right now, Ibn al-Arabi al-Mu'arraf. And there's also another kitab that have been written also, is the kutub that have been written regarding ahkam. As you know, there are hadiths that have written regarding ahkam. Like Bulugh al-Maram is a kitab al-ahkam, ahkam al-hadithi. And Umdat al-ahkam, they are hadiths, but they're written in ahkam, ruling. So when you read Bulugh al-Maram, you're just going to get rulings of fiqh from it. You're not going to get hasafdin from it. You're not going to get stories and seerah from it. It's ahkam, it's fiqh you get from it. Some scholars, what they did is their tafsir is also ahkam. They get rulings out of the Quran. Like that. Like, for example, the tafsir of Imam al-Qurtubi, the tafsir of Ibn al-Arabi. Their tafsir is ahkam, ruling. Like, for example, tafsir of Bakr al-Jassas, he's also wrote his tafsir and he's a Hanafi. So his kitab is matter, it's good. Even that though, you can sense some belief of i'tizal in him, i'tizal. Tafsir al-Qurtubi rahimahullah is a kid tafsir that has been published many times. The best publishing company, that the best tabaa that has come out for the tafsir al-Qurtubi is the tabaa Masriya, al-Kutub al-Masriya. It's the best. And it's one of the first tabaa'at that have been done. Na'am. وَهُنَاكَ There's also another that has been published of it. The second time that it was published, it got published نعم yeah, I didn't write that معلومات. But alhamdulillah, the best طبعة for a طالب العلم is that one. Also, one of the tafsir that have been written is إعراب القرآن للأكبري. The إعراب of the Quran of Akburi النحاس. And I'rab of the Quran by Akburi and the I'rab of the Quran of Nuhas. Their one is I'rab. They bring out the I'rab of the Quran, all of it, very simple and very good. And if you don't know the I'rab of the Quran, it will bring ishkal and weakness towards you knowing the Quran. Also, because we're talking about ulum al-Quran, one of the best books that are needed for a talib ilm before he reads the books of tafsir is the muqaddimat, the introductions to the science of tafsir. One of the big books or the great books that we studied or I taught was the muqaddimat fi usul al-tafsir by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. Also, manzumat al-zamzami, which is a poetry, is abridged and it has different shuruh and explanations. Also, Al-Itqan fi Ulum Al-Qur'an li Jalaluddin Suyuti, which is a Kitabun Jami', is a great book and it encompasses all of the information that you need to know about the science of tafsir. Burhan by Zarkashi, also beneficial and great benefits you come from it. Manahil Al-Urfan li Zarqani is also a Kitab fi Usul Al-Tafsir, which you find. But the issue is that the kitab is naqis, it's incomplete. Last one that a talib ilm should also have is Al-Qawa'id al-Hassan fi Tafsir al-Qur'an, written by Sheikh Abdurrahman Nasir al-Sa'di. It's one of the best ones that student of knowledge can benefit from because the wording is simple, the examples are there, and the Sheikh brings close what is far for a student of knowledge who is not able to understand.